By the end of this guide, you'll not only know how to use Cursor AI, but also be able to impress your friends by casually mentioning Command-Shift-P at dinner parties. Let's make sure this journey is as engaging and humorous as it is informative. Step 1. Getting started with Cursor AI. First things first, if you haven't already, you need to download Cursor AI. Head over to cursor.com, https://cursor.com, grab the installer, and get it running on your machine. Once installed, open Cursor AI by searching for it in your applications. If you're a Mac user, congrats! You're in the majority of people who think using a Windows machine for coding is like using a butter knife to cut a steak. After launching Cursor, you'll be prompted to log in. Do it. Cursor uses its own AI model, and you need to be logged in to take full advantage of all its features. Step 2. Understanding the interface. Once you're in, you'll notice that Cursor AI looks eerily similar to Visual Studio Code VS Code. That's because Cursor is essentially a fork of VS Code. No, we're not talking about the kind of fork you use for eating, but a techie fork, a copy of the software with some extra features sprinkled on top. You'll have the option to import settings from VS Code. This includes key bindings and extensions. If you've spent years perfecting your VS Code setup, this feature will make you feel like you've just found an old pair of jeans that still fit perfectly. Step 3. Setting up Cursor for your first project. Next, you're going to want to open a project folder. You've got two options. Open a local folder, easy mode. 2. SSH into a remote machine, hard mode, for those who want to feel like a hacker in a Hollywood movie. Choose your adventure based on where your code lives. For our walkthrough, let's keep it simple and open a local folder. If you're following along, pick any random project you've got lying around. It's time to let Cursor AI work its magic. Step 4. Customizing your Cursor experience. Now this is where things get spicy. Press Command-Shift-P to open the command palette. Think of it as Cursor's magic wand. Type in Cursor settings and start exploring. Here are some essential tweaks. Pro trial account. Cursor gives you a 2-week trial of their pro version, which unlocks extra features. If you're on the fence about committing, enjoy and see if it's worth the investment. Key bindings and extensions. If you've imported your VS Code settings, make sure everything is set up as you like it. Cursor should have carried over your key bindings and extensions, but it never hurts to double check. AI rules. If you're going to be working in a specific language, say Python for an iOS game, you can set language-specific rules. This ensures Cursor sticks to the script and doesn't go off on tangents like trying to code your game in COBOL. You can even set up project-specific rules by creating a .cursor rules file in your project directory. This allows you to define behaviors for each project independently, ideal if you're juggling multiple languages or frameworks. Step 5. Paranoia mode, protecting your data. Cursor AI lets you choose whether or not to share your data. If you're paranoid about companies peeking at your code, as you should be, enable the setting that prevents Cursor from storing your data. It's a little checkbox, but it could mean the difference between your code being a secret or becoming the next internet meme. Step 6. Making Cursor available from terminal. One of the coolest things about VS Code is the ability to open it directly from the terminal using code. Cursor AI has a similar feature, but you'll need to enable it. Here's how. Press Command-Shift-P again. 2. Search for shell command. 3. Select Install Cursor command. Boom. Now you can open Cursor in any directory just by typing Cursor in your terminal. It's like having a bat signal for your code. Step 7. Choosing your AI models. Cursor AI supports various models, including GPT-4, Claude 3, and even Google's offerings if you have an API key. You can even bring your own model, BYOM, by entering your API key under the Bring Your Own Model section. This is where things get really interesting if you want to test out different AI capabilities. Step 8. The Composer, your new best friend. Now, let's talk about the Composer. No, not the guy who wrote Für Elise. In Cursor AI, the Composer is a feature that allows you to generate code boilerplates, which is basically a fancy way of saying it writes the boring parts of your code for you. To use the Composer, press Command-I. This will open up a new window where you can enter specific instructions. For instance, you could tell Composer to generate a basic HTML-CSS JavaScript game. Watch as it conjures up your request faster than you can say Control-Z. Step 9. Fine-tuning your code with Command-K. Once Composer has done its thing, you might want to tweak the code. That's where Command-K comes in. This command lets you make quick changes to specific files. If the composer created a dull-looking game, just ask it to spice things up with a Tron Legacy theme. Command-K will handle the rest, ensuring your code not only works, but looks good doing it. Step 10, chatting with your code. Finally, we have the chat feature. This is like having a conversation with your code, where you can ask it to make changes, debug issues, or even generate new code based on prompts. The chat feature is particularly useful if you're making changes across multiple files or need to integrate documentation or web data into your project. Step 11, experiment, break things, learn. Cursor AI is incredibly powerful, but it's also a bit like a toddler. Sometimes it does what you ask, and other times it just draws on the walls. Don't be afraid to experiment, break things, and learn along the way. If the AI goes off the rails, just hit undo, take a deep breath, and try again. Now go forth and code. Just remember to thank me when you're a Cursor Pro. Happy coding!